So, yeah, one of my biggest problems has always been my movement in between the combinations. And basically what he's saying is, I'm completely wide open because when I throw the punch, my face is still there. So he's saying, get my face out of the way, get my head out of the way. And the other important point he said was that the boxing, pro boxing, we throw about 180 punches per round. Exactly. But we're just trying to stay active, keep the judges to think we're still in the fight. We're not really trying to win. Saying in MMA, every punch you throw, you want it to...
Every punch you want to knock out your opponent.
And the number of punches per round is...
You don't want to knock out, so you make a strong combo. Otherwise, too long combo, you can beat.
Oh, okay.
And each time you punch, you need to think of a total defense. Because it's not the 18-ounce glove. When you get touched with a short glove, it's over.
Yeah.
It's more video. Take time, and when you throw your punch, you're sure. But when you do it, it's 100% of speed.
Yeah.
You get hit. It's not just for walk, bam, 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 like in boxing. You can't. Yeah. You can't do this.
So look how big my boxing gloves are compared to an MMA glove or bare knuckles. Just walk around.
1, 4, uppercut. So, arm cover.
Yeah.
When this one leaves, the shoulder.
Yeah.
Okay, now. Sam.
Okay.
And we make some little submission when we are on the ground. We are on the ground, okay, like.
Okay. Okay, what he did there,
okay.
He's punching me. He's punching me, and because I brought my hands up to protect from the punch, I left my neck open, he's able to get rear naked choke. Yeah?
To disturb you, I punch.
Yeah.
Because when you're in this position, if you control one of my arm,
yeah.
I can't submit you.
If I hold one hand, he can't choke me, but he can
just
punch me.
That's not nice.
But we can't stay there all day.
Then I punch to release my hand, and release it, I go, and then I go. Just to bring your head down, catch under, and then come for trial. Why I put my leg on your back? Because the defense in this case is to roll on top. And if I don't catch you with my legs, you slip over and then you free. Ah! 20 years of experience. Before, when we start, as my generation, we came from one sport. We have one background. It can be boxing, Thai boxing, wrestling, jiu-jitsu, and then you go train the other part. But you already have 10 or 15 years in one sport. Now the new generation is different. In America and Europe, there's already MMA teams.
Yeah. Many of the kids, the first thing they ever did was MMA.
MMA, very young. So at 18 years old, you have great fighter,
who
have a nice background.
Yeah. If you look at the first 10 UFCs, you see one guy represents karate, one guy represents judo, and he really looks like that. And then already by UFC 5, this guy's coming in and they say, what's your martial art? Cross training. Already.
Yeah, specialized. And if you look at the first UFC and the last, we are far away.
Yeah, very
good. The old fighter is a complete athlete.
Yeah.
Not only a good on one sport and no conditioning or a big bar fighter.
Yeah.
Now he's a real athlete who have training, food nutrition.
Yeah.
And they walk. They do only that. They train three times per day.
Well, the other thing, you know, when I used to fight, when I was boxing, you had to be rich to buy videos. Oh, there were no videos. I mean, the films.
Yeah.
You're much younger than me, but when I was a teenager, you know, I couldn't watch films of famous fighters. Today, everybody can buy every DVD and watch 100 times.
You know, on pay-per-view, on internet, it's free.
Yep.
The download on internet, on the UFC, and it's a lot better than before.
Yeah.
We have a better fighter too. If you look at Georges St-Pierre, for example, now, the guy is competing in every kind of situation.
Unbelievable.
Wrestling, rapping, boxing. Oh, why not?
But his athleticism is unbelievable. He's not human.
It's a green body.
Yeah, he's not human, his body. He can jump, he can bend.
Yeah, exactly. He can run 500 meters, he can play soccer, he can do climbing or whatever. He's
good. Yeah, gymnastics.
He's good at all.
Yeah, crazy. You only like him because he's French.
That's nobody to face him.
One more thing I want to say on my show, we talk a lot about traditional martial art. So on my show, I have to show many things, you know, traditional martial art and respect.
I start by
and respect them.
Martial art. I start by
Taekwondo. Taekwondo. He's from France. They all do Taekwondo.
That's true.
Hey, do you know Khmer martial art is bigger in France than in Cambodia. Taekwondo is almost as big in France as it is. All these. I get email all the time from French people. But in the traditional martial arts guys, they want to learn 1 billion techniques, and I say to them, you're not going to win the fight with more techniques.
Exactly.
Muay Thai has 15 techniques, boxing has 6 techniques, but MMA is different.
MMA is all technique, but if you look at the fight, you finish the fight with the same techniques. It means that it's 10 that you can only pass, because after 5 minute round, you're all wet.
Yeah.
You can put a solution to a fighter.
Yeah.
Professional or not, there's only an effective one, like armbar, triangle, I mean, simple one.
Yeah.
That we win. We win with that kind of thing.
It's mostly
not the other. The other we learn just to be more complete.
You know,
and know how to escape all that thing. But you can apply it only on the first round.
Yeah.
And then after it's over.
Yeah.
Strike and simple thing.
Yeah, simple choke, armbar, triangle.
That's good in MMA. If you are in a spar, I can fight opponent who is better than me standard, but I know I'm better than him in ground. If I'm in a spar to train him in my game, I win.
Yeah.
That's different with the MMA martial, because when I fight in boxing, I beat the guy only in a boxing match.
Yeah.
Maybe that guy beat me in judo,
but it doesn't
beat me so easy.
Yeah.
But MMA, you win because you're best.
Yeah.
If you are better than the guy, you know how to bring him where you are better than him, don't go in his game, and you have better conditioning, because that costs more power.
Yeah.
I'm a boxer, but being in MMA costs so much more.
Yeah.
It's incredible. When we hit the round, 5 minutes round. 3 rounds, it's 2 rounds, 50 minutes. There is a belt fight, it's 5 minutes, 5 rounds, 5 minutes each round. Incredible, and you go on the ground, holding, pushing.
What did I do wrong?
You can just do a fight, I do a trick.
Yeah.
With this one, just add that one. You shoot with the short foot, the left one, to the liver.
Okay.
In
general, what am I doing wrong? What's my basic mistake?
My mistake, you was focused too much on my punch.
Uh-huh.
I do something, you focus right away on what I'm doing. I think I'm set up in something.
I'm focusing too much on your punches.
Yeah, that's normal. At the beginning, it's always like this because it's hard.
You're
focused on everything.
You're also a much better puncher than most guys that I see in, you know, Cambodia or someplace where I'm sparring. That's part of it, so I'm a little bit afraid of your punch.
Yeah.
One more. You said my legs are lining up.
Yeah.
My legs are getting in a straight line.
Yeah, well, you come on a straight line. This means you don't have a good balance if you receive kick from the side.
Yeah.
Both sides, you will lose the balance.
Okay.
And then if you want to strike me, you use only one side. You can't use the side on the left one.
Okay, so if my legs are lined up too much sideways, then I can't kick.
Opening the same size of your shoulder, large as your shoulder, like this.
Okay.
Then you can hit with the left side or the right side, whatever.
How's your back, mate?
Got my back because I was standing sideways.
Yeah. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.